A 65-foot vessel. A 6 to 8 foot wingspan. On the water, the Connecticut River Quest. Overhead, a once endangered species.
We went through a period of time in Connecticut, about 50 years, where we had zero eagles nesting here.
But flies in Essex? Well, they do. Here, the story of the bald eagle continues to rise.
It's been a steady increase over the years in Connecticut, basically from 1992, when we had the first nesting pair come back into Connecticut.
It was the comeback of the Connecticut River responsible for the eagle's ascension.
They're fish eaters, and when there was a lot of pollution in the rivers, it wasn't killing the eagles, but what was happening is it was causing the eggs to be weakened, and their shells were being crushed.
The return of the eagle, now changing the view on the other end of the lens.
In this day and age, a lot of populations are going down because of what's happening within the environment, and this is always good to see that it's going up.
Now we have 45 successful nests last year, 83 babies produced in Connecticut.
Captain Mark has been setting his sights on eagles for 18 years.
The leaves are off the trees, so it's easier to find things. We have visiting eagles in the winter that come down because it freezes up north.
And in winter, it doesn't take an eagle eye to spot them. A pair of binoculars usually does the trick.
It's just so much fun to get out in the winter when you're normally not associating yourself out on the water. And going to see things like the bald eagles. It's a beautiful bird.
Eagles can be seen in many locations across Connecticut, and in the winter, eagles will migrate south to find food sources. Food is often harder to find during the colder months, which could cause energy stress. So it's important to observe from a distance. Each January, the DEEP Wildlife Division participates in a mid-winter eagle survey for the United States Geological Survey, where volunteers can often help. Rachel Piscatelli, Fox 61 News.